This is Pete Feenstra on Saturday the 11th of December 2011, unbelievably live at the Boom Boom Club, where we're celebrating 11 years of Four Bills and a Ben meets the Mods, which is basically Four Bills and a Ben that Andy Hamilton on my right, the man with the sax. Hi Andy.
Hi there.
And Johnny Warman, the man with the voice and Hello. Incredible high energy on my left, founded way back in
1989, not 98.
How long's that?
21 years.
That's unbelievable. I thought we were talking about 11 years.
That's for the Mods.
Right. But so you people out there in TV land don't know, for those of you that don't know, the Four Bills and a Ben was the original soul band that morphed into the Mods via the Carnaby Street Chameleons. Is that right?
Yeah.
Do you want to explain how that happened?
Yeah, we were, through Pete, we were asked to do the play at the Steve Marriott Memorial Concert. And the name of the band was the Carnaby Street Chameleons, but the actual promoter said we'd never get it on the poster. So we had to make it up real quick, and we came up with the Mods.
Yeah, and you recorded on that album, of course?
Yeah, yeah. We had four tracks on it.
Filmed some of the thing, as we will tonight.
Yeah.
And we were talking at the Boom Boom Club in Sutton, because this has become a kind of annual event where the Four Bills and the Ben actually meet the Mods. So for the purposes of people out there, again, the Four Bills and a Ben was basically a soul band to start with.
Well, it still is. Started out with some of the members of Status Quo, John Rhino Edwards on bass, Jeff Rich on drums, and Andy Baum, I think, was the first keyboard player. Okay. But, you know, due to various commitments, they sort of came and went as they were, depending on what the band was doing. And myself and Johnny Warman, and who else was? Steve Bird,
yeah.
I believe, on guitar.
Great guitar player. Yeah.
And a couple of us are still hanging in there after all this time. And it was initially, we just played charity things, which was beautiful and great fun.
And schools, and wasn't it?
And schools, yeah, we used to play at schools, which was nice. And we just enjoyed doing it, so we just carried on.
Some of those kids have grown up now and come to the gigs. They're only 14 now, it's worrying.
But it is still fun to play this music. That's the reason why we're still doing it, basically.
Yeah, and your background, Andy, is very diverse, as is Johnny's, and you've gone back to classical soul to start with, I suppose.
Yeah, well, I mean, I used to be in soul bands in the 70s. I mean, I used to play with Edwin Starr. That was my, you know, in fact, somebody emailed me a picture of myself looking like a hippie during in 1978 with Edwin Starr.
So I've done all
that stuff, and, you know, I like that music, and it's good fun to play at this kind of high energy level as well, you know.
And I guess that's the link between Four Bills of Soul thing and the Mods, Johnny, isn't it?
Yeah, because, I mean, the mixture of the material that we had was basic soul, like soul stuff, and more obscure songs, wasn't it?
Yeah.
The people that didn't know.
I think that was one of the things that we wanted to do, was to try and focus on stuff that not all the other soul bands were playing, to try and just do stuff that they weren't awfully familiar with. I mean, we do quite a lot of favourites now, but there are a couple of tunes that some of these people have never heard before. You know, sure. some...
And you'll be doing some of that tonight, presumably.
Well, it's Four Bills meets the Mods, so time might be a bit limited, but we'll see what we can do.
Yeah, so about 11 years ago, I guess, or thereabouts, you actually did start on a tangent, which is the Mods, or became the Mods, and it's been very successful.
Yeah.
And you've now recorded your debut DVD in Austria, the Boom Boom Club, and Monte Carlo. Is that right?
Yeah, that's right. And Saint-Tropez. And Sutton.
They played it topless.
I actually mention that on stage every time I start off all the most romantic ones and end up with Sutton, but it is a great venue here.
Yeah, and you've played over a decade here now. It's been great. But the Mods is a mixture of the Who, the Kinks, the Small Faces,
Pretty Things, the Doors, and then sometimes we...
Spencer Davis.
We add it up a little bit, a bit more, a bit heavier. But the thing was, when we started Four Bills, there were certain songs in there that sort of pointed towards this 1964 to 1970
classic era
of music, which and is what we love.
And you've gone the further step now to the third part, or the third show that you now do, the Mods Vida Rockers.
Yeah, yeah.
Which is a meeting of the stuff we just talked about, and...
And gives us the opportunity of putting in heavier material, like brings in bands like Zeppelin, Arjun, Deep Purple. But it never gets too, and Hendrix, it never gets too sort of involved. Only a few of those sort of songs.
But that's when Andy steps off the stage, of course.
Well, I go and open the wine and make sure it's the right vintage, and then I just wait for them to start playing something I recognise, and then I jump up and join them, you know.
But anyway, you've done incredibly well. You've brought that, as you say, 1964 to 70, up into the 2010s.
Yeah, my years as a teenager.
And your musical career, Johnny, so everybody knows, is Ringo Starr, Peter Gabriel, Bearded Ladies.
And Asia.
And Asia, of course, yeah. And you've written a lot of songs for different people.
Yeah.
And this is sort of going back to your youth, isn't it?
Yeah.
Rediscovering the old
45s. The stuff that turned me into the musician that I became, I think for all of us, were touched by such great bands in that through that period. Yeah. Really.
So there it is, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight and somewhere down the line, you're going to see four bills and a band meet the mods. You may just see a four bill show, you might just see a mod show, but whichever one it's going to be, they're all great. Thanks for talking to us, guys.
Pleasure.
Please come and see us again. Prakash on the camera, Pete Feenstra, thank you, and good night.